tendency when we're working in the studio to kind of work in a bit of a vacuum, really. We don't really listen to a great deal of music. There were certain records that came out at the time that we listened to just for recreation, really, which kind of made us feel that there was a bit of a rebellious spirit coming back to rock and roll, which was cool, which was Primal Scream and 6x7, but I wouldn't say that they actually sonically influenced the record. And when I went home, I would listen to Scott Walker or Serge Gainsbourg, old school stuff, you know, which again didn't really have that much of an influence on the record. And you're the one who's always used and broken us. Maybe enemy, but so another line. It's a remedy. Just there was a very there's kind of a vacuum of political kind of like consciousness, really. It's like music became very, very vacuous in the UK, basically. And we had bands like Oasis, we had bands like Travis, Stereophonics, you know, who were kind of really making music which didn't really mean a great deal, and we just found it kind of refreshing, basically. But at the same time, sort of like, even though I think that that the act of expression in itself is kind of like a political gesture, what we deal with is that we deal with sort of like, I guess, the politics of human emotion more than anything. And what we are trying to do is we're trying to make an emotional connection with the listener. We're trying to essentially say something about the human condition and say something about humanity. Totally. I mean, trying to move people, you know, trying to kind of like, you know, touch their hearts, really. And I think because the music is so honest, it actually does that. There's a great deal of passion, honesty, emotional vulnerability that exists within the music. So I think that's why people kind of understand it, and it touches their hearts to such a big extent.
Happy birthday to me.
To you, not really. It's not really a genre of music which I find very satisfying. Scott Peering was a legendary plugger, who is basically somebody who gets your records on the radio and takes your records to TV stations and radio stations. And he was kind of like, he was sort of like the Don, you know, kind of like the top man. And you could always really trust his opinion. And he was also an incredibly suave individual, and he always got it right. And he died while we were making this record. And at the time, we were actually doing the lyrics for Slave to the Wage. And we kind of felt his presence, really. And he had he gave us a great deal of advice at the beginning of our career. And when this album came out, we had a feeling like, you know, we wish, you know, we could ask him so many questions if he was still here, really. And so it was somebody that we felt that, you know, that should be, you know, remembered. Best musician of the 20th century. The best singer of the 20th century, Billie Holiday. There you go. I just absolutely adore what she does.
Sometimes I say if I just could get away with my man.
No, I think it was just kind of at the beginning, you know, kind of thing. I've actually quite like the new Eminem single, Stan. I think it's a very good song. And sonically, I like very much the female vocal in Stan. I think it was just kind of, we were lobbing Eminem in with Limp Bizkit and Korn and things like that. You know, this very kind of like negative sports metal vibe, you know. It just seemed to be We've always liked hip-hop that has a message, really, but, like, when hip-hop just talks about itself all the time, it becomes very boring. I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood by the animals.
I'm just a soul whose intentions are good. Oh Lord, please don't let me be misunderstood.
It's quite a complex question to answer, really. You know, as musicians, you try and find a name for your band that represents you, and you never really do. The most important thing, because basically, the names for bands lose their meaning after a little while. They become a series of sounds that you associate with people and music, really. The most important thing about choosing a name for a band is that if you can imagine 40,000 people screaming it in unison,